Hey, what is up, guys, and welcome back to Football Discussions. We're up to Mock Draft 5.0. I'm at a weird spot right now. I just finished the SATs and all that, so I should be able to post more often, which is really my goal. I mean, I'm trying to go like once or twice a week, which would be like really awesome to do. And we're also in a really weird spot right now. On draft order, draft news, and all that. So, I mean, obviously, the news of Chase Young, who claims he might be staying, is obviously a risk here that we're gonna have to worry about. But I'm gonna call his bluff, and from now until it's confirmed whether he's going or staying, I'm just gonna mock drafts with Chase Young in him, because when you're a top five pick or a guaranteed top three pick, it's hard to pass up that opportunity, and I don't see Chase Young doing that. So I'm gonna call his bluff, and we're gonna mock most of my drafts with Chase Young. Maybe I'll do, like, if you guys want to see it, one without Chase Young, because he is one of the most dominant prospects in this class. But regardless, let's get right into a mock draft 5.0, starting off with the first overall pick, Joe Burrow to the Cincinnati Bengals. This kid is a beast, one of my favorite players that I've ever seen play college football. Huge fan of his. Like him a lot. The arm strength isn't one of the best in this class, but his accuracy, his poise, and just his toughness is there. You hear announcers talk about it all the time, how this guy doesn't really have that nervousness that other quarterbacks may have. No matter the stage that he's on, no matter the point in the game, whether it's fourth quarter, last drive, or the first drive of the game, he's always calm, cool, and collected. And I think that's why a lot of people like him. And I think that's what's going to make him a great NFL quarterback. Just won the Heisman. So I think this is a great pick for Cincinnati, who's obviously in desperate need of a quarterback. Up next, we have the Giants getting Chase Young. I think this is a kind of obvious one if they are picking at second. Chase Young is a beast. He's racked up, I think, close to 20 sacks. It might be 18 or 19 at this point. Great pass rusher. Great moves. He knows how to get by most offensive tackles in the NFL, I would say, would have trouble guarding this guy. Very talented, huge fan of his, and I think he really brings something to the table that the Giants are missing. There's rumors that Leonard Williams is going to leave, so that pass rusher that they had isn't really going to be there. Not that Leonard Williams is anything special, but Chase Young is a generational talent. I think it's very important for the Giants to bring him in, and I would love to see this pick try to get New York back on track. With a third overall pick, I know a lot of people are speculating about Tua Tagovailoa, whether he's going to come back or whether he's going to stay at Alabama another year, and if he does come to the draft, when he's going to get drafted. The thing for me is he's going to miss the combine, and we don't really know his status, so I'm not going to pick him top 10 right now. It just doesn't make sense as a fan of football and someone who's paid close attention to the draft for the past 2 years. Now, and I know that doesn't seem like a long time, but believe me, I have done all my research and this and that. And I don't see Tua being a top 10 pick right now. And honestly, I see him eventually deciding to stay at Alabama. But regardless of all of that, I do think that I'm going to mock him as if he's declaring for the draft. So you will see his face later in the draft later. But I know I'm going on kind of a tangent here. Regardless, the Dolphins are going to take offensive tackle Andrew Thomas here at the number three spot. Really good player, great pass blocker. And after trading away Laremy Tunsil, the Dolphins are in desperate need of a pass blocker protects that blind side. And I think this is a really good pick for the Dolphins. With the fourth overall pick, I have the Washington Redskins getting cornerback Jeffrey Okuda out of Ohio State. Fantastic player, great ball skills, probably the best man coverer we've seen in a really long time. I think he's comparable to Denzel Ward. I think he might even be better than Denzel Ward. I think he did get snubbed from that defensive back of the year award. They did give it to Grant Delpit, who's another fantastic player, but I do think Jeffrey Okuda is the best defensive back in this class and probably best defensive player aside from Chase Young. But the Redskins, you could have them going pass catcher route here. I know that they do need a boost on their wide receiver core. Obviously, Terry McLaurin has been playing fantastic in his rookie season. However, I see them just rocking with Terry for one more year. Maybe you can even get a wide receiver in a later round, and they're going to go defense in the first round, because honestly, that defense, especially the secondary, isn't performing. You got to give Landon Collins some help out there. The cornerbacks are getting toasted day in and day out. I think it's really essential for the Redskins to get a cornerback here, and there's none better than Jeffrey Okuda. So I like this pick a lot for the Skins. With the fifth overall pick, I have the Lions getting Derrick Brown, defensive lineman out of Auburn. The Lions are kind of in this like hybrid 4-3 that they run. So regardless, you could have Snacks and Derrick Brown in there at the same time. Or if you're running this like 3-4 that they sometimes run, you could even put Derrick Brown at right end. He's a very athletic defensive lineman, one of the more athletic defensive linemen we've seen. He knows how to get to the passer, and he's also a terrific run stopper, and the Lions definitely need that. So I like this pick a lot for Detroit. With a 6 overall pick, it's pretty obvious, especially in the past few weeks to me, that Kyler Murray has no pass protection. He is getting sacked constantly. He has to run outside the pocket, and I know that's what he's good at, but I mean, it's hard when you're a rookie to have guys like Aaron Donald in your face all the time. So I think Tristan Wirfs is a great player for the Cardinals to bring in. Really good offensive tackle, great pass blocker, also can open up holes for the run, which is kind of a rare, and I'm not going to say rarity, but something that isn't really the focal point of offensive linemen. But I mean, Tristan Wirfs is very good at it. He's probably one of the best run blockers on Iowa as well. So I think this is a great pick for the Cardinals. And they definitely, like I said, need to shore up that offensive line. So it just makes sense. With the 7th overall pick, I have the New York Jets getting their pass catcher of the future, Jerry Jeudy, wide receiver out of Alabama. Very clean route runner. Huge fan of his. Gets open like none other in the NFL or in college football, and probably get in the NFL someday soon. But very talented wide receiver, and I think the Jets desperately need help at that position. They got to give Sam Darnold someone to throw the ball to consistently, and I know Robbie Anderson has kind of come on into his own here, but is he going to be with the Jets next season? There's a lot of questions about this Jets offense, so it just makes sense that they're going to bring in an all-pro wide receiver like Jerry Jeudy. Not an all-pro, but you know what I mean. With the 8th overall pick, we're going back-to-back wide receivers here. CeeDee Lamb from Oklahoma to the Jacksonville Jaguars. The Jaguars really are another team that need a wide receiver. And I mean, I know you can point to guys like DJ Chark, who has come on this year. You could even say like D.D. Westbrook, who was a Heisman candidate 1 year at Oklahoma as well. Marquise Lee isn't getting the job done. So I think it's really important for the Jaguars to get Gardner Minshew or Nick Foles a target who is a beast like CeeDee Lamb, and that's exactly what this kid is. I mean, he's so fast, great release off the ball, and he's also a great route runner. Not as good as Jerry Jeudy, but he also plays kind of bigger than Jerry Jeudy. He goes up for those jump balls, uses his size and strength to his advantage, and is really going to be a menace for defensive backs for years to come. With the 9th overall pick, we have the Los Angeles Chargers getting their quarterback of the future. It's clear to me that why can't I think of the Chargers quarterback? Phillip Rivers, of course, probably a future Hall of Famer, is out of Los Angeles. They are disagreeing. You see him getting in fights with his coaches constantly. He seems kind of moody, angry even, in Los Angeles. And the Chargers really need something new, and they need something that they're not getting out of Phillip Rivers. It wouldn't be a surprise to me if we see him benched in Week 16. But that's all hearsay. I'm going to go with Justin Herbert here. I think it just makes sense. Very strong arm, kind of raw though. Reminds me a little of Josh Allen coming out of Wyoming. Now, Justin Herbert is far less raw than Josh Allen, but he has a cannon of an arm. He just needs to learn how to contain it and use it to his advantage. The accuracy isn't all there. But regardless, I think it's a good pick for the Chargers to bring in this kid. Even if you sign Phillip Rivers to a one-year deal, at least you have this player to put in when things start going south next season with Phillip Rivers. So I'm a huge fan of Justin Herbert, and I think this is a good pick for Los Angeles. With a 10th overall pick, and this just makes sense to me, Isaiah Simmons going to the Denver Broncos. There's a lot of holes on this Denver team, but I think it's clear that they've maybe found their quarterback of the future in Drew Lock. I'm not sure yet. They do need offensive line, but with Wirfs and Thomas off the board, I don't see them reaching on another offensive tackle here when they have so many other needs. And if you guys watched the Chiefs game on Sunday, you saw Travis Kelce tear apart that Denver defense in the middle of the field. And so they need a linebacker/box safety that can cover tight ends and running backs out of the backfield and even get on wide receiver sometime. And Isaiah Simmons is exactly that. He's a freak athlete, plays both positions at Clemson, linebacker and safety. Great coverage linebacker if you're going to put him there, but he also hits hard and knows how to fill gaps. So he's also a fantastic run stopper. This is a very good player, probably my favorite player in the class, and I think it's a good fit for Denver. With the 11th overall pick, the Panthers are getting their safety of the future in Grant Delpit. Won the Jim Thorpe Award, best defensive back in the nation. Now, he has had his tackling problems, but I've said this a lot about Grant Delpit. While he isn't the best tackler, he has range that you just can't teach to a safety. I always say you can teach tackling, but you can't teach the range that this kid has. He comes from one side of the field to the other. He knows exactly where the ball is going to be. When he's on the field, LSU's defense is so much better, and there's a reason why he wears seven at LSU, and that's because he's the best player on the field. Super talented, huge fan of his, and I think he's going to be a good fit in Carolina. With a 13th overall pick, I have the Falcons getting AJ Epenesa out of Iowa. Very good edge rusher, and the Falcons really need one. I mean, their edge rushing situation isn't terrible, or just their pass rushing situation isn't terrible, but it definitely needs improvement. I mean, you have Grady Jarrett, who's a fantastic defensive tackle, and Tack McKinley isn't awful either, but they really need another edge rusher here, and I think AJ Epenesa is the perfect guy to put across from Tack McKinley. Knows how to get to the quarterback. Really good pass rusher in the Big Ten, which is, you're going up against the best of the best offensive linemen and defensive linemen. So it's fun to watch him battle all those top tier talents in college, and I think that's going to translate directly to the NFL. And I think this is a really good pick for the Falcons. The 14th overall pick, I have the Oakland Raiders getting wide receiver Henry Ruggs out of Alabama. Speed burner, great hands on this guy. Probably going to have the fastest 4-yard dash out of anyone in this combine, if I had to guess. Really talented, really, really fast. I know I've said that a lot, but also not a bad route runner. And I think the Raiders really need that big play maker that they're missing in that offense right now, kind of open things up in the playbook. You can also run those jet sweeps that a lot of people love to run nowadays. He's just a really good athlete. And I think Jon Gruden is going to get a really fun toy to play with in Henry Ruggs. With the 14th overall pick, I have the Browns getting Jedrick Wills out of Alabama. Now, these two Alabama offensive tackles have rotated throughout my draft board, and I mean they're both pretty good players. Jedrick Wills and Alex Leatherwood is the other one I'm referring to. Both have their ups and both have their downs, but I think regardless of placement in this draft, the Cleveland Browns have to get offensive tackle, unless they can get a guy like Trent Williams in free agency if he does end up leaving the Washington Redskins. But regardless, the Browns, like I said, they need to protect Baker Mayfield. He's getting pressured, and I know he hasn't had the best season, but a lot of that can be attributed to his limited time in the pocket. And I think Jedrick Wills is a good player, and can really help up or help that Cleveland Browns offensive line. With the 15th overall pick, another one of my favorite players in the class, I have the Colts getting Javon Kinlaw out of South Carolina. Very good player again. Huge fan of his as well. Great run stopper. I mean, very underrated. Probably one of the better run stoppers we've seen in a very long time. And he's very underrated as well. Derrick Brown is obviously the best of this interior defensive line group in this draft, but Javon Kinlaw is a close second, and the Colts really need some help on that defensive line. I mean, obviously their linebacking core is really good, getting better and better. Darius Leonard is a beast, so why not shore up this defense even more and get Javon Kinlaw? I know a lot of people have them going quarterback after Jacoby Brissett has kind of cooled down here in the second half of the season. But I mean, they signed him to a 2-year deal. What's the worst that can happen? You play him for one more year. And if it goes south, and you can draft Trevor Lawrence next year, Justin Fields next year. So there's a lot of prospects that are out there. So I have them going defense in this one. With a 16th overall pick, Philadelphia's secondary blows, man. We saw it versus the Giants last Monday night when Darius Slayton was toasting their best cornerback. They really need help, and Christian Fulton is a very good player, more of a zone coverer than man coverage. He kind of struggled in man coverage in the second half of the season, while he was actually kind of good in man coverage in the first half of the season. Regardless, he can get better and better with his coaching staff, which, in my opinion, the Eagles have a fantastic coaching staff. Just they've been ridiculed with injuries and all that, which is why they're not having great success this season. But regardless, Christian Fulton, great player, and the Eagles secondary needs a lot of help. With the 17th overall pick, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers going Jonathan Taylor, running back out of Wisconsin. Now look, Jameis Winston is so good and so bad at the same time. I personally really want him to get that title of most passing yards, most passing touchdowns, and most interceptions. I think that would be really funny. But I think he's toying with the Buccaneers coaching staff enough to the point where they're going to be like, should we just franchise tag this guy for one more year, see how he does? Or even should we give this guy like a 3 or 2 year deal and see how he does? So I think Jameis Winston's getting re-signed. The Buccaneers aren't going to go for a quarterback just quite yet. However, they don't have this every down running back that most teams need, in my opinion. I mean, we see it with the Ravens. You have a guy like Mark Ingram, who's really good. The Browns have a guy like Nick Chubb, who's really good. Just all these type of every down running backs are elevating these offenses. And while the Buccaneers have a guy like Rojo or Peyton Barber, it's just not enough. And Jonathan Taylor, I don't care what you say, is the best running back in this class. He just won running back of the year as well. You could argue DeAndre Swift or Travis Etienne, and I would understand those arguments, but Jonathan Taylor has done it for 3 years straight at Wisconsin. Beast. I mean, every year he puts up stats. He's been a Heisman finalist 2 years. He came in fifth this year, although he wasn't a finalist. So, I mean, this guy is so good, so talented at the running back position, and I think the Bucs really need to fill that void, and I think this is a match made in heaven. With the 18th overall pick, I have the Oakland Raiders getting the linebacker of the future, Kenneth Murray, out of Oklahoma. This guy's a beast, and his draft stock is quickly rising. Plays coverage pretty well. I mean, I would say it's not a strong suit, but he's not bad at it, and he's so strong, and hits those gaps so hard, and is a really good run stopper, running back or linebacker. He follows the ball very well, which is a rare trait, and he's just an athlete. So whatever problems he has can obviously be taught, and that raw athleticism doesn't come at the linebacker position very often. So he kind of reminds me of Devin Bush from Michigan last year, who we see thriving in the Steelers defense right now. So I really like this pick for the Raiders. With the 19th overall pick, I have the Tennessee Titans getting Kalyvon Chaisson out of LSU. This kid's a beast. You want to talk about a pure athlete? Kalyvon Chaisson fits that perfectly. Great edge rusher. A little raw. I mean, he's just so strong and so fast, and that's why he gets the quarterback. But I mean, once he gets in contact with NFL level offensive tackles, he's going to need to work on getting out of their grasp and getting to the quarterback more effectively. But his speed and strength is really going to help him be groomed into a great pass rusher in the NFL. And the Titans need someone across from Harold Landry, so it just makes sense to me that they go with Kalyvon Chaisson. With the 20th overall pick out of the Jaguars, getting that cornerback that filling the cornerback void that Jalen Ramsey left. Now, Trayvon Diggs is more of a slot guy and probably the best slot cornerback in this class. Very talented, great in man coverage, needs a little help in zone. But regardless, he's quick, he's fast, and I really like this pick for the Jaguars. With the 21st overall pick, I have the Dallas Cowboys getting their safety of the future, Xavier McKinney, out of Alabama. Another really good safety with great range. Not as good as Delpit, but I mean, he knows how to get to the ball. Great in zone coverage. He can even play a little man. I mean, you see Alabama running these like six deep defensive back sets where you have Xavier at the linebacker position, so he can even play a little box linebacker if you need him to, and a little nickelback as well, so he can cover that slot guy, and he's also, like I said, a great zone coverer. So I'm a fan of Xavier's. With the 22nd overall pick, I have the Dolphins getting Tua Tagovailoa out of Alabama. Like I said, Tua is a mystery right now to me, and I know a lot of people are going to be like, why don't the Panthers draft him, or why don't the Titans draft him, and this and that. The Panthers, to me, I think are going to go after a guy like Teddy Bridgewater, or even keep Cam Newton after Kyle Allen's lack of success recently. And the Titans are going to keep Ryan Tannehill. He's going to pull a Nick Foles, and they're going to be like, wow, I don't want to sign this guy, but due to his recent success, we're going to have to. And they're going to sign him to like a 2-year, a lot of money deal, and he's not going to be good next year. So they're kind of in a weird spot, but I don't see them drafting quarterback first round. Maybe they take their replacement second round. But regardless, I think Tua is going to fall to this spot, just the way everything's playing out right now. If he does decide to declare for the draft, then as he goes to pro days after he heals, then he's obviously going to get better and his stock is going to rise again. But right now, it's around this range for me, and I think the Dolphins are going to get their quarterback of the future here in Tua Tagovailoa. With a 23rd overall pick, I have the Dolphins going all offense in this first round of the draft. I mean, it's a very deep defensive class, especially in the secondary where they need some help. I mean, they need help all across the board, but I think at this rate, they're going to get the best player available to them, and they've gone through their entire depth chart of running back this year. We've seen it in front of our eyes, whether it's Patrick Laird, Mark Walton, Kalen Ballage, Kenyon Drake, who I know was traded, but they need a running back that can consistently put up numbers for them, and I think that DeAndre Swift is the guy. A great running back, has a lot of talent, a lot of speed, great acceleration, and he's very strong as well. He can break those tackles. So I think DeAndre Swift is a fantastic player, and the Dolphins won't miss their opportunity to draft him here. With a 24th overall pick, the Minnesota secondary needs some help. Xavier Rhodes is getting pretty old, and their defensive back situation isn't great at all. Paulson Adebo is a very underrated defensive back from Stanford. Great ball skills, really good in man coverage. Can even play that slot role, but he's more of a boundary type guy. It reminds me a lot of Byron Murphy from Washington, but I like him a lot, and I think the Minnesota Vikings, like I said, need help in the secondary, so they won't pass up on this opportunity to grab him here. With the 25th overall pick, I have the Buffalo Bills getting their wide receiver of the future in Laviska Shenault out of Colorado. Right now, the Bills wide receiver core is not bad, actually. They're playing very well, Cole Beasley and John Brown, but both those guys are getting up into their 29s and 30s age, and that's where regression starts to hit in for wide receivers, especially guys that have been playing in the league consistently for this long. So Laviska is going to be a really good piece to bring in for Buffalo. Great player. Plays like I think he might be like 6'3", but he plays like he's 6'6", really goes up for the ball, and seems 10 times taller than he is when he's out on the field, just the way he plays. And he's also a really good route runner too. So I'm a big fan of this pick, and I think the Bills will nab him here. With a 26th overall pick, I have the Chiefs getting their interior offensive lineman of the future, Tyler Biadasz, out of Wisconsin. I know the graphic says he's a running back out of Georgia. That's my mistake, but we all know he's not a running back out of Georgia. Another guy that's really good, and if he falls this far, which, I mean, just with the sheer talent that there is at other positions, and teams are going to get too excited to miss on their guy, I think Tyler Biadasz is probably a top three or top four offensive lineman in this class, and teams are going to be sorry for missing him. But like I said, there's just so much skill position talent in this draft that it's hard for teams to pass up on it. But regardless, the Chiefs need some interior offensive lineman help, and I think Tyler Biadasz is a great fit for them in Kansas City. With the 27th overall pick, we have the New Orleans Saints going with T. Higgins out of Clemson. His stock fell at the start of the season. I mean, a lot of people have had him at like a top 15 pick to start the year. And then as the season went on, his stock, you know, kind of drifted down. But now it's kind of climbing back up steadily. And I like to see that for T. I mean, he's a great player, great hands, probably some of the best hands in this class. He does not drop the ball a lot at all, and the Saints really need some wide receiver help. Michael Thomas can't do it all. They can't seem to find a tight end that's under the age of like 28, so they're obviously constantly rotating this tight end position, and their wide receiver core is good, I guess. I mean, Ted Ginn's probably going to retire soon, and he's getting up there in age, so it just makes sense for them to bring in a young buck, great wide receiver like T. Higgins. With the 28th overall pick, I have the San Francisco 49ers getting Creed Humphrey, the interior offensive lineman out of Oklahoma. Another really good offensive lineman here. He plays center, but he's kind of versatile. He can play both the guard positions. Knows how to open up holes for the running back. And it's such a run-heavy offense like the 49ers. I think it just makes sense for them to get a better interior offensive lineman for their team. With the 29th overall pick, I have the Patriots getting Curtis Weaver, edge rusher out of Boise State. This guy... I look at a lot of mock drafts, and he is not in the first round for a lot of them. So I understand people are like, who's Curtis Weaver? And like, well, why do you have him in the first round? But I mean, he's second in college football in sacks right now. He has been top three in like the past 2 years at Boise State. And I know he doesn't go up against great offensive linemen like, in the Big Ten or the SEC and over in the Mountain West where he plays. But, I mean, we see a guy like Khalil Mack, who's dominating the NFL out of Buffalo. So you really never know, and you shouldn't base it all on conferences. And Curtis Weaver is just a great talent, and the Patriots need help off that edge. They're not getting constant pressure on the quarterback, and I know they could take offensive linemen, which is another weak spot of this team, but it just makes sense to me that they shore up that defense that's already so good. With the 30th overall pick, I have the Green Bay Packers getting wide receiver Justin Jefferson out of LSU. I don't know if it's just because I like watching LSU so much this year that I have a lot of their players in the first round, but I see Justin Jefferson sneaking in here. I mean, he's so good. Had a 1,000-yard receiver, a 1,000-yard season. Sorry, English is hard for me. And quietly had one of the best years of college in college football. So I really like this pick for the Packers. They need a wide receiver, kind of like the Saints across from, instead of Michael Thomas, Davante Adams this time, kind of help Davante get out of that triple coverage situation and maybe only get double covered. So I really like the Packers taking a wide receiver, and I think Justin Jefferson is going to be their guy. With the 31st overall pick, I have the Seattle Seahawks getting Yetur Gross-Matos out of Penn State. Really good edge rusher, pretty underrated. I mean, his size isn't all that, but if you play him at like a 4-3 outside linebacker position, or even I guess a 3-4 end, he wouldn't be awful. Big fan of his, and I think that he could really progress into something great. With the 32nd overall pick, I have the Ravens getting their linebacker of the future. Obviously, they traded away Kenny Young, and they need a little more help at the linebacker position. There are some studs on that team, but Dylan Moses is fantastic. Tore his ACL to start the college football season, so we didn't see him play this year. Also, another Alabama player that I'm not really sure if he's going to go back to Alabama or come back. But right now, until these guys declare or specifically state that they're coming back to college, I'm just going to have them in my mocks. Dylan Moses is a great linebacker, probably would have been a top 5 pick in this class, or at least top 10 if it weren't for his injury. So I really like the Baltimore Ravens getting him here. All right, guys, that's going to do it for today's edition of my mock draft. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you want to see more mock drafts, please subscribe to the channel. Mean a lot to me. And if you really like this one, please leave a like. We'll see you guys next time.